Welcome, Star Kids and friends. Today's passage is Genesis chapter 3, verses 1 to 24. In the previous passage, we read about the creation of man and woman, Adam and Eve, and all mankind have a special place in God's creation. They were created with a need for relationship and were created to have a relationship with God. God created them in his own image with the ability to think, love, and worship. They could make choices and they could talk to God. Man and woman were a very special creation. In today's passage, we read about the fall of man. God was their creator and their king, and he gave them the authority to rule over his creation. Adam and Eve were happy in the Garden of Eden and spent time each day with God. God gave them just one rule, and they disobeyed it. Their decision to disobey God had terrible consequences for all of creation. Before we read today's passage from the Bible, let's pray and ask God to teach us. Father God, I thank you so much that the entire Bible points to your salvation and your plan to save us, Lord, and have a relationship with you. Father God, I just pray as we read about the fall of man, we can see your plan at work, God. Take your word, plant it in our hearts, and help it to grow. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Genesis chapter 3. Now the serpent was more crafty than any of the wild animals the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God really say you must not eat from any tree in the garden?" The woman said to the serpent, "We may eat fruit from the trees in the garden, but God did say you must not eat fruit from the tree that is in the middle of the garden, and you must not touch it or you will die." "You will not certainly die," the serpent said to the woman. "For God knows that when you eat from it, your eyes will be open, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." When the woman saw that the fruit of the tree was good for food, and pleasing to the eye, and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and ate it. She also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate it. Then the eyes of both of them were open, and they realized they were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together and made coverings for themselves. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock and all wild animals. You will crawl on your belly and you will eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put an enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel." To the woman he said, "I will make your pains in childbearing very severe. With painful labor you will give birth to children. Your desire will be for your husband, and he will rule over you." To Adam he said, "Because you listened to your wife and ate fruit from the tree about which I commanded you, you must not eat from. Cursed is the ground because of you. Through painful toil you will eat food from it all the days of your life. It will produce thorns and thistles for you, and you will eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your brow you will eat your food until the return to the ground, since from where you were taken, and from dust you are, and dust you will return." Adam named his wife Eve because she would become the mother of all living. The Lord God made garments of skin for Adam and his wife and clothed them. And the Lord God said, "The man has now become like one of us, knowing good and evil. He must not be allowed to reach out his hand and take also from the tree of life and eat and live forever." So the Lord God banished him from the Garden of Eden to work the ground from which he had been taken. After he drove the man out, he placed on the east side of the Garden of Eden a cherubim and a flaming sword flashing back and forth to guard the way to the tree of life. What is God teaching you today in that passage? Take some time to think about it. Maybe read it over again, then write it down in your soap journal. And don't forget to share what God is teaching you with someone else.